So a new artist I've been following and looking more into is Daido Moriyama. He's this Japanese photographer who's really well known for his street photography and taking a lot of high contrast, grainy black and white photos. And I've been looking through his photos and also bought a book of his recently called How I Take Photographs. And it's about how he takes photographs. So today I'm going to talk about Daido Moriyama, his book, How I Take Photographs, and the takeaways I took from him. So in photography, I think there's a lot of emphasis on concepts. What is concept in street photography? Why does it matter? Does it even matter? Daido Moriyama in his book talks a lot about concept, and my first takeaway from his book and his thought process is that concepts aren't as important as we think. He says, "I've always said that photographers should put aside concepts or themes when they go out on a shoot. Of course, I understand young people want to have a conceptual basis for their work. I was the same way starting out. But even in my earliest photographs, the collection titled Yokosuka, for example, I knew I wanted to take pictures of Yokosuka, but I had no agenda. I never thought to myself, right, I'm going to explore the political tensions in Yokosuka or anything. I just thought, I'll go out and shoot some pictures. I felt no different when I later went to Shinjuku or Buenos Aires or Hawaii. If you go to places with an agenda related to what's going on socially or politically and try to take shots that underpin that agenda, you're not going to get anywhere. The photographer should just shoot whatever he observes, using all his senses, and if possible, unselectively." He's basically saying, don't put too much weight into concepts. But, you know, why is that unimportant? And it has a lot to do with the nature of photography and the nature of a photo. He says, "What I learned from these experiences is that the passage of time has this ability to completely erase things from your memory. And what you're left with is simply what's in the photograph. You know, of course, in the instant you press the shutter button, a memory of the image flashes across your mind, together with the various things you're thinking about in that moment. Aesthetic considerations, concepts, desires. But whatever's in the photograph stands completely independent of those thoughts. That is what remains, and it's completely independent. When a photographer points his camera towards something and presses the shutter button, of course he does it with some kind of intention. But the image that is captured in that instant will always contain vastly more information than the person behind the camera had in mind. Any concept or theme the photographer might try to express will be utterly insignificant compared to the amount of information stored instantaneously in the image itself." So it really sounds like you can have all these concepts in mind and have everything in your head before you take the photo, but once you press that button and shoot an actual photo, what's left is just whatever is in the f***ing picture. Like, that's all someone else is gonna see, what is visibly in that picture. Along with the idea that concepts aren't as important as we think, Daido really talks about just shooting. When asked about advice he would give, he says, get outside. It's all about getting out and walking. That's the first thing. The second thing is forget everything you've learned on the subject of photography for the moment and just shoot. Take photographs of anything and everything, whatever catches your eye. Don't pause to think. That's the advice I give to people. You know, even if you're just shooting anything and you're shooting pretty casually, he was doing a photo shoot with the author of the book, and they were just chilling, taking photos, and he says, you know, the photographs we've taken here today, we've taken quite casually. Even so, you can never discount the possibility that some young person will come along in 10 years' time, take a look at them and think, hey, these are astounding. Photographs are things that can be brought to life over and over again, any number of times, depending on their environment. To put it another way, the only way you can ensure that a shot will ever be at all meaningful is if you take it. Don't think too hard about it beforehand. Don't be too self-conscious or rational. Just press the shutter button. There will be all the time in the world for other people to come along later and attach whatever implications or meaning they like to it. So yeah, in Daido's words, just shoot it. Like, if you want to shoot something, just shoot it. A big part of what lies underneath just shooting it is what he calls desire. But above all, you have to have desire. That desire the photographer must feel in the instant he takes the shot. If you don't have desire, you won't see what's there. I'm talking about the desire you feel in that moment when you see something that compels you to take your shot. It could be a woman or anything. Desire is all around us. There's a huge limitless supply of it. it's important to be true to that desire. To take a photograph that is at all interesting or meaningful, you must become one with that desire when you press the shutter button. And he really advocates for fuck all the rules. You know, if there is one rule, that rule is that there are no rules. Any photographer worth his salt would want to question any derogatory label and be prepared to ask, well, what's wrong with that? Now when I take shots of Tokyo, I find myself purposely going to places that I would have avoided before from fear of doing anything cliche and photographing them. But if you're too fastidious and fussy and you won't try this or that, you end up missing out. So do whatever you want, do what you want, do what urges you, do what compels you. But you know, but even though Daido says just shoot it, you still have to pay attention to what it is you're shooting. He says, don't just select any old thing. Choose the object deliberately and carefully. If they're going to take a picture of a house, for example, I tell them I expect them to use up at least 10 rolls of film on that one house. My reason? You're not going to develop a discerning eye unless you hone your ability to give something your full and undivided attention. Recently, I see so many young people, I guess they're photography students, with cameras in their hands walking about in the streets. Well, that's great, but if they're just taking photographs in a random way, I don't think they're going to grasp the most important point, which is that you've got to have an understanding of what it is you're doing, what you want to capture. That's why I always tell my students to choose their subject and observe it closely. Give it your undivided attention first, and only then capture it on camera. And take lots of shots, because you won't see what it is you're taking unless you take lots of shots. At least, that's true with street shots. Without a good number of shots, you won't really see what it is you're taking, and you won't understand what you want to take. And if you can't see what's in front of you, and have no idea of what you want, how do you expect to be able to understand anything about photography? So shoot everything and anything, but make sure you pay attention to what it is you're shooting and what exactly you're seeing. But the interesting thing about Daido is that even though he says, you know, concepts aren't as important as you think, just shoot everything and anything, just don't think about it too much, he is a guy that thinks a lot and thinks too much about it. He writes a lot of essays on the meta aspects of photography, like what is photography? In one essay titled A Dialogue with Photography and From Photography to Photography, he says, another part feels this deep lack of certainty about all the scenes I pass through in any given day. What did it all mean? I know I've encountered and seen countless objects, people, scenes, but can I really say definitively what they were? Can I really say for sure what I encountered? There's this strong doubt I feel about myself and about photography. So for a guy who tells you like, yo, don't think about it too much, just do it. He's a guy who thinks about it a lot. And that really wraps it all together of what I think the ethos and attitude of Daido Moriyama and what his photography is. Don't think about it too much, but thinking about it too much. So to summarize, concepts are not as important as we think. Because of that, just shoot it. Don't question why, don't think about it too much, but pay attention to what it is you're shooting. Always be asking, so what? Forget the rules. Rules are not important. And do question what it is you're doing. Why did I shoot this? Or like, what is it that I'm shooting? But only after I've taken the photo. To think about all this stuff before taking the photo, you don't want to think about why you're doing something while you're doing it. Just do it and figure out all that stuff afterwards.